coming out here today for the reveal of Project 412. It's been a long road to get here. I remember almost 10 months of the day standing over there with a logjammer once was, bittersweet times, but gave way to a lot of preparation, speculation, and now, of course, anticipation as we get ready to showcase what will be Kennywood's next great attraction coming for the 2019 season. So before we get fully into the proceedings, just want to, first off, thank you all for coming out here. Welcome to our guests and some of our friends here that joined us, some of our special dignitaries, including our mayor of Duquesne, Nicole Nesby, thank you for coming out. Wes Mifflin, Mayor Kelly, and some of the behind-the-scenes folks from both Duquesne and West Mifflin that we work with very closely on a lot of this behind-the-scenes stuff. So thank you for joining us. Representative Austin Davis, representative up in Harrisburg, along with Representative Bill Quartz and Kathy Osman from Senator Jim Brewster's office, couldn't be here today. Also, going a little out of order, but County Councilman Bob Macy, our representative here in downtown for Allegheny County, thanks for coming out today as well. Also, just a quick thanks to and a recognition to Darby from Mattel, who's with us here today as well. We've a lot of focus, of course, that's been on Project 412 and speculation, but we're still hard at work and almost finished getting Thomastown ready for guests to enjoy and get into. So we're just 8 days away from that. So we're really excited about that, and I hope that a lot of you will be back here with us in 8 days again as we cut the ribbon and do the grand opening of Thomastown. We got a lot of awesome stuff going on here at Kennywood, of course, and our 120th anniversary season. But, of course, what's brought us all here today is Project 412. And just to start, we're going to kind of go back to not quite the beginning, but in the start of June, where we revealed for the first time the Project 412 Ride Scratcher. So what we wanted to do here was find a fun way to bring people into the know a little bit and give some clues as we started to tease out what our next ride was going to be. So we put that Ride Scratcher out. It had 9 boxes. We gradually scratched every box to reveal a number, and those numbers are significant statistics that relate to the ride itself. But we only gave you the numbers, we didn't give you any details. Then on Independence Day is when we unveiled phase 2 of Project 412, which was a word search, and that had words and phrases that are common descriptions for amusement rides, and it was up to our guests to find the words in the word search, take the numbers that we had revealed, and figure out how to connect the dots, how everything related. And the first 12 people that did that correctly will win a pretty awesome chance to be among the first riders when this ride opens. Some really cool behind the scenes access and some cool swag as well, which we'll get to shortly. And we did actually, we had more than 2,500 entries and about 40 people get it right. So not a high percentage, but they're out there. We'll give some shout outs here shortly. But before we do that, we're going to get to the reveal that I think most people have been waiting for of those numbers as we start here. And I want to get off the stage so I can see with everyone else. So the first number, if we progress forward a little bit. So the scratch card, and then the word search, of course. And then, so let's go ahead and next one. Okay, so 197 was the first number we revealed, and 197 is tallest inversion. So you're going to be going upside down 197 feet off the ground. 2, 3. This is the hardest one, probably. This is where most people got tripped up. Records. So this is going to set 3 records, and we'll get to that in a little bit. 24. Pretty straightforward, but most people got this. Passengers. 220. Height. The max height for this ride, 220 feet. 120 seconds. This is a 2 minute long run. Speed, 75 miles per hour is gonna be the top speed on this bad boy. 9, this is another one that trips people up a lot. 9 is the number of inversions. 50 is the lift angle, the lift hill, is going to be about 50 degrees up in the air. So it's pretty steep. You'll see it soon. 4,000, this one, pretty straightforward. That is the length. So all that adds up to all that's going to add up to a record-setting roller coaster, which we're going to get to in a minute. First, maybe shout out these 12 people, first 12 to get it. You can see this was not just something of local interest. We had people from all over the country enter and win. Our actual grand prize winner, first one person to get it completely right. Go back there. Go back. Just the back one slide. So Brian Sanchez from Downey, California is our grand prize winner for Project 412, and then John Thompson, Natrona Heights, Connor Hayes from Shadyside, Zachary Strader, Arlington from Virginia, Eric Bafumo from Plano, Texas, Zach Kahn, he only put four digits in for his zip code, so he's from parts unknown. Jennifer and Michael Yellen, both from Zelianople. I don't know if that's a parent-child couple or husband-wife couple, but they both got it right within 10 minutes of each other. John Cooley from Dayton, Ohio, Justin Doty from Romulus, Michigan, and finishing up with two local people, Donna Karintak from Carmichael's and Jeremy Koval from my hometown of Monroeville. Well, congratulations to those 12. And thanks to everyone that participated. So what does that all add up to? What do all those numbers add up to? We can go to the next slide. All that is going to add up to, as we said, a record-setting roller coaster from SNS Worldwide. And they are one of the world's largest amusement ride manufacturers, and I believe the nation's largest ride manufacturer. And so quickly, I want to introduce to say a few words about this record-setting project, Pete Bartow from SNS. Pete!
Thank you very much. I can't tell you how excited I am to be here at this historic park. It's one of my favorite parks in the world, quite frankly. SNS, if you're not familiar, we've been around almost 25 years now. As you mentioned, we are locally based here in Logan, Utah, in the United States. We feature, our portfolio features just short of 50 roller coasters, 177 tower rides, and over 300 family thrill and kids rides. So give you a little background on myself. I actually I have a real nice connection with this park because I live in Pennsylvania. My family is originally from this area, and my father actually worked in the steel mills his whole life. So I have a real tight connection to the Pittsburgh community, to this park, and to everything about this ride. I always say I kind of grew up with you, you know. It's a special coaster for me and a special coaster for our company. So enough about that. Let's kind of get into the coaster. Nick said a few of the things, but I'm gonna add a little more detail and structure to the ride itself. Coaster itself, like you mentioned, will be just over 4,000 feet of track, 24 passenger trains manufactured in the U.S. It's going to be made up of almost 3 million pounds of steel for the track and structure alone. It's going to require 78 flatbed trucks. That's 7-8 flatbed trucks just to get the track here to the park. As it turns out, this is not only a custom ride for SNS, but it's actually the largest roller coaster that our company's manufactured. So we're very, very proud to be part of this. We'll go over, for the enthusiasts out there, we'll go over a couple of the elements that the ride is going to have, and then I might get to see a little more with it. We have a new element. There's actually 9 unique elements on the ride, including a new element called a banana roll. We have an over-the-lift hill double inversion, a dive loop over the lagoon, and what's going to probably become a great photo op for the park, two-sided track truss arch bridge over the midway, with an airtime hill on the top side and a zero-G stall on the underside. Like I said, I see that as being destined as a great photo op for everyone in the park, riders and non-riders alike. Like I said, did I mention that there's U.S. record 9 inversions, 220-foot lift hill, and of course that that first inversion at 195 feet. So we're, like I said, S&S is very excited about it. You know, we want to thank the great people here at Kennywood who've worked really, really closely with us on the ride. You know, I want to thank Jeff, Chris, Jerome, Rob, and the countless people on their teams for the collaboration on the ride itself. I also like to thank the folks out in Utah who I believe are probably watching this as well right now because they're excited as we are. So a little shout out to the folks in the engineers, the designers, the project maintenance team, and all the staff there. It's going to make this ride incredible for this community. So we sincerely appreciate the trust that this community and this park has put in S&S to deliver an intense roller coaster experience for the people of Pittsburgh like no other in the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pete. So this is usually the point where we get to what everyone's most anticipating, that simulation of what the coaster ride is going to look like. But we're actually only kind of finishing, we're only kind of at halftime of this announcement here today, because this roller coaster is going to be for sure the star player, but it's only a piece of the puzzle, only a part of the team for what's going to be happening in this corner of Kennywood right now. It's something that we're really excited with, fits in perfectly with our 120-year history of innovating in the amusement industry and connecting to our community. We are going to be opening up and what's going to be an unprecedented collaboration for the amusement industry, never been done before. This will be the first time here at Kennywood. We'll be setting another trend like we've done many times, like I said, over our 120 years. And this is going to be a whole special area of the park. And we're going to be bringing in some longtime friends into the Kennywood family that will be joining us now on a permanent basis going forward. And it looks like they are here, right? About now. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pittsburgh Steelers! For the Steelers to say a few words here about what's coming. That is Steelers Country at Kennywood Park. Ryan.
Thanks so much for having us. On behalf of the Steelers organization, just wanted to say how excited we are to be a part of this project. We're extremely excited about the connection to families and to the Pittsburgh market and region. We think they'll be really happy about what we've collaborated on here. Before I go any further into details, I just want to recognize Chris Hoke, former player, lives here in Pittsburgh. He's got a big family, he's enjoyed the park, so we thought he'd be. And of course, Steely McBeam is out here to join us. I know you've probably heard a little bit about the area. One of the things we're excited about is the roller coaster itself. We've collaborated with the folks at Kennywood. The name of the coaster is actually called Steel Curtain, which we feel like is really important. The branding elements and all the activities that will be football themed and focused. We're very excited about how you'll be able to experience Steelers brand, Steelers football, NFL football here in this environment and this very family friendly place. So again, thanks so much on behalf of the Steelers organization. We're very excited to be a part of this partnership and we're really looking forward to 2019. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ryan. Okay. All right, without further ado, I know everyone's been waiting for it, so let's go ahead and let's roll. Let's take our first ride together on the Steel Curtain.
Hahner, here we go.
For fun. You can see right here, the Terrible Tower is one of them. This is a little more of a kid-themed climbing structure. You get all the way up, and there's actually different levers within the ride that are within the ride, within the attraction that will spin the towels on the top. So that's something that we're really looking forward to. And let's go to the next slide. And then two-minute drill. I hear someone kind of compare this to, excuse me, to top golf with footballs. But you're trying to hit targets, so there'll be a lot of that. Pardon me, a lot of things like that, and clear my throat. And what we're gonna, this is all also gonna be, you know, state of the art in another way, because we're gonna be working with some technologies where you'll be able to track your performance and different things throughout the day. You saw in the background a 40-yard dash. You can track your time doing some of those drills, your accuracy, and how many targets you hit in this, and the big video screen that is in the entrance plaza will actually pull up throughout the day and essentially even throughout the season your performance compared against other people. You know, so a really quick way to track and just engage beyond the actual experience that you're doing. So those are some of the early things that we're looking at. Again, we're really excited about all of this, and it's a brave new world. We're excited to be part of it, pioneering it here at Kennywood Park. A place that's been leading the way in our industry for more than 120 years now, going into year 121 in 2019, maybe the best one yet. We're really excited about it, and we look forward to welcoming all our guests, all fans, people from all over the nation and the world to enjoy these attractions here with us at Kennywood. Enjoy the rest of your day here at Kennywood. Thank you.